should, Jane, it should have a note on it saying that it's normal batteries.
So that's the one I should take?
That's the one you should take, yeah.
All right, we just don't have any normal batteries, so that's why I'm concerned. Here is a Saw-whet owl. Not looking at you. Looking at the person who's holding it. So Dan here behind me is going to do all the processing and the measuring, and as he's doing that, focusing, we'll walk you through it and we'll talk about what we're doing, and then at the end we'll walk around and let you guys snap some pictures, get a really good picture, and then at the end we'll walk them out. You guys can walk out with us, and we'll let this little guy or gal go. Very focused on me. So the first thing we're doing here, and Marie talked about this in the presentation a little bit, is we're going to take a wing measurement. And we do this in two different ways. We do a natural wing cord. So what we do is we use this special little ruler with an edge at the end. So we put the wrist of the wing all the way up against this edge, and we get the natural wing cord, which if you look at a bird's wing, it has a slight curve to it, so it helps them fly. It's aerodynamic. And we get a number with this natural shape, 134, and then we get a flattened wing cord, and that is what the Europeans use, and since this is a boreal species, just in case it ever ends up somewhere or somebody's using a flattened wing cord number, we get this number just in case. 139, so it's a little bigger than the natural wing cord number. And then we get a tail number, and that's just one number.
Is it millimeters you're telling me?
Yeah. Yes.
Sixty-five.
You can see this bird isn't really struggling at all. She's very calm. I'm sure she's not very happy about it. There's a little beak clicking going on. If you hear that snapping, that's not a happy noise, but they don't get too stressed out by this. We do it as quickly as possible and get them going. So now here what we're going to do is, we're going to weigh her, or him. I think with those numbers, it's probably a female, 139. So we're going to weigh him. This looks a little stressful, but it's the quickest and most accurate way to get a weight. So she goes right upside down into this little tub. That is a heavy little bird.
She must have risen.
Yep, so it's very possible she ate a meal recently. And out she comes. Great. And now we are going to do bill. In the bill measurements, we use this handy dandy little tool here, and we take what is called a culmen measurement, and that is from the nostril, or the nare is another name for it, to the tip of the bill. Now, all this doesn't help us determine really the age or the sex of the bird like some of the other measurements do. It's always good to have the most data possible. So just in case somebody somewhere is using this data for some kind of research project, we go ahead and take the number. It can be difficult because they do have feathers covering parts of their beak, and they do like to snap.
Thank you.
because I'm driving you close down the line again.
I'm gonna call it 10.7.
All right, now we're gonna look at the winks. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna flip all the lights off. We're gonna get this flat light. So, hopefully our black light's strong enough. Can you guys see this pink color?
Mm-hmm.
All right, that is the porphyrin in these wings. And if you guys can see, we have a molt pattern going on here, what we call a molt limit. It might be difficult to see in the back. All right, I just jumped with the bird. Oh, there we go, perfect. So you can see we have this chunk of pink, and then a chunk of blue, and then another chunk of pink. So what we're going to do really quick while the lights are still off is we're going to give these feathers numbers and mark down what the numbers are. It's going to sound a lot like when you're at the dentist and they're saying those numbers for your gums. But what we're doing is we're aging the feathers to brand new feathers, bright pink feathers, or older feathers, blue feathers, and that will help us age the bird.
Right wing.
Right wing. Now we're going to do the other wing. So what we're looking at here is to see if the molt is symmetric, which is what should be happening, or if it's asymmetric, which it occasionally happens. So we're going to give that a look too.
One. The rest are twos.
So slightly asymmetric, I think, there.
Yep.
All right. Now,
lights, please.
Somebody in the back, there's a little thing on the wall with a slide that goes up. Beautiful. Thank you. We are going to call this an after second year bird. So there's different generations of feathers here. And what that means is this isn't a hatch year. It wasn't born this year. It's not a second year. It wasn't born last year. It was born more than 2 years ago. And that's all we can tell about this bird. So it looks a little goofy, but what we're doing here is because there are feathers on the feet, we have to spin the band around so no feathers get caught in the band.
Just to confirm that was band number.
Cool.
That looks good.
Band number 17.
Does that bother the bird at all to have that on?
It does not. It weighs, I believe, 0.03 grams. There's a lot of regulations about how much weight you can put on an animal when you're adding a band or a transmitter or something, and I think it has to be less than 2 or 3% of the animal's total body weight, and this is way less than that. It doesn't even register to them, so.
Yep.
adopt the same owl as Rob, so if anybody else wants to adopt. Try to take a sweet photo.
Okay, what I'm going to do with the bird is I'm going to walk around. You have two options. You can either take a picture of it, or you can take one finger and run it down its back like this.
One finger.
Very gently.
Very